to turn her head to the left, and then I'm going to turn it to the right. And I want her to be able to do it without moving her feet. So I'm going to start on her left. And if she moves her feet, yeah, we're just going to spin until she stops. And I'm not using any pressure of my feet. I'm just using the pressure of the reins. See, she stopped. I'm going to release the pressure. And I don't want her moving forward, so I'm going to back her up. Back. Being a little stubborn today. You got to fly. Okay, now I'm going to do it again. Back her up again because she moves her feet. And I'm only doing this so I can get her to stand still. And release the pressure. No, back. Good girl. See, that's what I want. I want her to be able to just flex her head and neck without moving her feet. Good girl. Now I'm gonna do it on the right side. And again, I'm not using any pressure with my feet or my leg. And we never know how long we're gonna be spinning. Just whenever she decides to stop like that, we're gonna release the pressure and not let her eat grass. Back. We're gonna do it again. And I'm just making sure I'm keeping my foot out. Even if I'm just pulling my foot out a little bit more than what I usually do, I just wanna make sure I'm not putting any pressure. I'm just trying to make sure I don't put any pressure with my leg, because that's what I do when I turn her, when I'm riding around, and I don't want to confuse her and give her the the wrong impression of what I want her to do. Back up. There's hay here that's one feed. I'm going to walk her over here. Now let's try the right side again. Now one thing we gotta remember is that horses have a good side and they have a bad side. And the right side for most horses is the bad side, and it definitely is for Ginger. I like to call it her dumb side because it's the side she always gets hurt on. Seems like she wants to move everywhere. There we go. And again. Good girl. She didn't move with my side. Okay. Oh. Okay, let's try this again. No. Back up. And we're just gonna keep doing this until she finally gets it, like she did on her left side. Now I'm gonna check her left side. I still have a lot to do on her right, but I'm gonna do her left side again to make sure she's still able to flex. And she did a little bit. She moved her feet slightly, but I'll take it because she's still learning. But we're gonna do her right side. And release the pressure. And this is how horses learn. They learn from the pressure and release method. You put the pressure on them until they do what you would want them to, what you ask of them, and then you release the pressure to let them know that what they did was right. Good girl. Now this side, it's definitely taking a lot longer than what the left side did. Good girl. Now, since she didn't move her feet that time, I'm gonna pat her. So she did a good job. And back her away from this grass, because it seems like all she wants to do today is eat. Now, see what she's doing? No, stop. She moved her feet again. Now, sometimes they can get it once, and then you go to do it again, and they just move their feet again. It's like they don't completely understand, but this is gonna take more than just this session. I've already done a couple sessions with this before, and as you can tell, we're not making much improvement on the right side. I'm gonna get out of this grass again. Okay, now we're gonna do the right side again. For some reason, hey, no. She's kind of trying to bite my boot. Now, if she does end up trying to clamp down, she's going to get a little tap on the nose to know that she's not allowed to do that. But she's mostly just doing it with her lips, so I'm not going to worry about it too much. Kind of making me dizzy. There we go. If you're someone like me who gets dizzy really easy, this is going to be one of the worst things that you have to teach your horse to do. But it's all worth it in the end once you get them to do what you ask. No, she stopped and then took off again and released the pressure. I'm going to try. I realize I've kind of been grabbing up higher, but I'm going to do it lower. There we go. Oh. We're kind of getting it now on the right side, but this is going to take a lot of practice, a lot of time. This isn't something that you can, there we go, good girl. This isn't something that you're going to get down in, you know, 5 minutes. I mean, there's always that chance that you have a horse that learns it real quick, but this is something that Ginger isn't catching on too fast, so it's taking a lot more time. See, I should do that last one. She did really good. She just flexed, and this one she moved her feet a little bit again. We're back moving her feet again. There we go. Release the pressure. And back up. Ginger, back. She's being very stubborn today. I can say she's normally not this stubborn. She's usually well behaved. Good girl. But it could be because she's also sore, because she's been getting a lot of exercise for the past few days. But even if she's sore, that's no excuse to be disrespectful. Pressure and go back at it again. Good girl. I think I'm just gonna stop it there. We have a lot more that we need to work on. And it's going to take probably a couple more sessions, 2-3 more sessions. And thanks for watching. I hope you were able to learn something from this. See you next time on Equine Passion.